Dear students, we will continue with the exercise number 4. With the exercise number 5. We have to solve two exercises. After solving these two exercises, we will complete this lesson. Inshallah, in our next class, we will start lesson number 1 from section prose. Okay, section prose, lesson number 1, Durusun Minal Quran Il Kareem. Lessons from the glorious Quran. Suratul Quraysh is there. Suratul Quraysh. Another surah. Suratul Quraysh is there. And Suratul Maun. Suratul Falaq. Suratul Nas. 4 surahs are there which we will study in our next class. Today we are continuing with the exercise number 5. The same topic. The topic is Al-Murakkab Al-Izafi. Exercise number 5. Section Grammar. Lesson 1. Exercise 5. Okay. The name of lesson 1 is Al-Murakkab Al-Izafi. Okay. Lesson whom, exercise 5 is whom be tashihil jumal, whom be tashihil jumal. Okay, whom be tashihil jumal means correct the following sentences. Okay, correct the following sentences. Correct the following sentences. He will ask you, there will be a minor correction in the sentence that you have to rectify and correct it, rewrite the sentence in a correct form. He will give you the incorrect sentence. For example, it is given here, hadihi khalamul mudarris. Hadihi khalamul mudarrisi. This sentence is given here. Now we have to identify the incorrect word which is not suitable in the sentence, then we have to write the correct sentence. Okay. Hadihi qalamul mudarrisi. Hadihi is a feminine word. As you know that you have studied in first year in the demonstrative pronouns, hadihi is used for female gender. Hazihi means this, and it is used for female gender, whereas Haza is used for male gender. Hazihi is for feminine and Haza is for male gender. Now we have to observe that Khalam is a masculine gender or a feminine gender, because Hadihi is pointing towards the Khalam. Hadihi known as Ismul Isharati and Khalam known as Musharun Ilayhi, indicated towards. These are the words which are used to indicate towards something. Hada, this, ye. Hadihi, this, ye. But in Arabic, there is a variance. Difference is that Hadihi is used for female gender and Hada is used for male gender. Now we have to analyze that. We have to observe that hadihi is used for the male gender khalam. You had learned about the male and female gender in first year, intermediate first year. Khalam is a male gender. Why? Because it does not have any sign of feminine gender at the end of the word. among the three signs of feminine gender. Three signs are taun marbutatun, taun mudabbiratun, roundta. Roundta is not here. The three signs of feminine gender are roundta, alif hamza, and alif maksura. Alifun mamdudatun, alifun maksuratun, taun mudabbiratun, or taun marbutatun. These three signs are the indications of feminine gender. Okay, we can recognize the word whether it is a male or a female, then we have to observe whether the signs appears at the end of the word or not. If the word is any one sign is appearing, then that word would be considered as feminine gender instead of male gender. Here, no, such case is not here. Khalamun, here mim is here at the end of the word, it is considered to be a male gender. When we point out towards a male gender with using asmaul isharati, demonstrative pronouns, then when we are pointing towards the male gender, we have to use the isma ishara of male gender. We have to use the demonstrative pronoun of male gender, that is haza. So now we get a clarification that hazihi is used for female gender. Okay. Now what we have to do, we have to replace hazihi with haza. We have to replace hazihi with haza. In answer, jim we will write, jim stands for al-jawab, like we write a for answer. Okay, jim stands for al-jawab. Instead of hazihi, we will write hada, hada. After writing hada, we cannot leave this remaining sentence. We have to rewrite the whole sentence. Got it? Dear brothers and sisters, please keep in your mind that correcting the incorrect word is not enough. We have to rewrite the whole sentence after correcting the incorrect word. Okay. Hadihi, instead of hadihi, we will change hadihi with haza. We will write khalamul mudarris as it is. Okay, khalamul mudarris. What is the meaning? Meaning is, this is the pen of teacher. Or another translation, this is teacher's pen. Teacher's pen. Teacher, here teacher is a common noun. Okay, in English, teacher is used for male gender as well as for the female gender. Here, al-mudarris means teacher. Here, it refers to the male teacher itself. When we are pointing towards a female teacher, we add lady teacher. Okay. Hada qalamul mudarrisi, this is the pen of the teacher. This is teacher's pen. Got it? How to rectify the incorrect word? Then we have to replace with the correct word. Then we have to write the whole sentence. Okay, now we will take another word, another sentence. Sentence number B. B. B is here. Hada sa'atu hamid. Hada sa'atu hamid. Hamidin. Okay. One more thing you are noticing here, that khalamul mudarris is mudaf and mudaf ilay. Khalamu is al-mudafu and al-mudarrisi is al-mudafu ilayhi. In this way you can recognize the mudaf mudaf ilay as well. But here the heading is qum bi tasheehil jumal. Correct the following sentences. We have to identify the incorrect word. we have to replace with the correct word and write the whole sentence. Hada sa'atu hamidin. Here, hada sa'atu hamidin. Here, the word is sa'atu is here. Sa'atu contains the feminine sign. Sa'atu has feminine sign. That is golta, roundta, ta al mudabbira. Okay, taun mudabbiratun, taun marbutatun is here. This is the indication of feminine gender. So, what we have to do? We have to use feminine demonstrative pronoun. Haza is used for male demonstrative pronoun, masculine demonstrative pronoun. Haza is a masculine demonstrative pronoun. Instead of haza, we have to replace haza with the feminine demonstrative pronoun, that is hadihi. Hazihi, we have to write the same sentence. Sa'atu hamid. The meaning is, only for understanding. You are not supposed to write the meaning in the exam. Just you have to correct the sentence. We are giving the meaning for understanding purpose. This is Hamid's watch. Hamid's watch. See. Sentence number 3. Kaifa, how? Al-Mudir. Kaifal Mudir Al-Kulliya. Kaifal Mudir Al-Kulliya. So here, Kaifa means how. Al-Mudir, the principal. Al-Kulliya to the college. So here, actually they want to say, how is the college, how is the principal of the college? How is college's principal? They want to say this one. So here we are noticing that Alif Lam is prefixed to Al Muzaf. Whereas the rule says Muzaf cannot take Alif Lam in the beginning. So we have to drop this Alif Lam from here. Then we have to rewrite the sentence. Kaifa Mudir Rul Kulliyati. Okay, this is the correct sentence. Kaifa Mudirul Kulliyati. How is the college's principal? D is Al Khalam Al Waladi Fil Jaibi. The translation is pen of a boy is in the pocket. So here also the same case. Al khalamu al waladi, khalamul waladi. This is muzaf and muzafile phrase. So we have to drop alif lam from the beginning of the muzaf because muzaf cannot take alif lam in the beginning. So we have to drop alif lam. We have to rewrite the sentence. Khalamul waladi, pen of the boy, fil jaybi, is in the pocket. Got it? Take down the translation. How is the college principal? How is the principal of the college? The pen of the boy is in the pocket. Write it down. Later, inshallah, in our next class, we will do the next exercise. Okay, time is remaining. We can do it today only. Write it down or take the snapshot of it. Then we will continue. The last exercise is, he will ask you to translate the following sentences. Shall I rub the board? One person having doubt. Okay, we will take your doubt in the doubt clarification session. Keep the hand raising. Don't unraise your hand. Let the hand raising. After solving the exercise number 6, we will proceed. If the time will not permit us to proceed, we will solve the 6th exercise and we will close this chapter. Inshallah, in our next class, we will start section prose, lesson number 1, Durusun Minal Quran Il Kari. Lessons from the glorious Quran. Okay. Shall I rub the board? Or shall I wait for a while? Now, okay. I will rub this side. Kumbi tasihi jumal. Exercise number 6 is, let me rub this Bismillah as well, so that we can use the board. Exercise 6, Tarjim translate ila logatika, ila logatika. It means translate into your own language. Translate into your own language. Translate into your own language. The first sentence is A. Baitu Tajiri Amam al Masjid. Baitu Tajiri Amam al Masjid. Answer B. Baitu Tajiri means, how we will translate this Baitul Tajir? This is a phrase of Muzaf and Muzafile. Then we will write the house of trader is in front of Masjid. The house of trader is in front of Masjid. Got the translation? Next is Haza Kalamullah. Haza Kalamullah. We can translate it as, this is word of Allah. This is the word of Allah. Or another translation, this is the speech of Allah. Next, see, Hada Khalamu Waladin. Hada Khalamu Waladin, the translation is, this is a boy's pen. This is a boy's pen. This is a boy's pen. Now I shall rub this side now. sentence number 4. Fourth sentence. Muhammadun sallallahu alaihi wasallam Rasulullah. Muhammadun sallallahu alaihi wasallam Muhammadun sallallahu alaihi wasallam Rasulullah. What is the translation? The translation is Muhammadun Rasulullahi. The translation will be Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah. MUHAMMAD. Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Got it? Then the last sentence. Al-Ka'batu Baytullah. Al-Ka'batu Baytullahi. The Kaaba is house of Allah. Another translation. The Kaaba is Allah's house. Now, this is the end of first lesson from grammar, from section grammar. This is the end of lesson number 1 from section grammar. Inshallah, in our next class, we will start section prose. Durusun minal Quranil Kareem. That is a very interesting topic of prose.